the wings are done. I'm going to do the neck feathers while my background is still really good and wet, because it's so much easier to do that while the paint is wet. I can work wet into wet, and that way I get nice soft feathery edges. It's like on these wings back here, I was able to drag those wings into the background, and it gives them that soft edge, so it feels like there's movement and it makes them fall back. These wings, I wanted a little harder edge on them because they're closer to the foreground. Hard edges come forward, softer edges go back. So that makes that wing go back in the distance, whereas this wing then will come forward. So I've mixed some combinations of my mud, which is alizarin crimson plus ultramarine blue, and then added orange to it, cadmium orange, and also a little bit of cadmium red light, just to give, we want more of a, almost a burnt sienna color for these neck feathers. This, the light's going to be hitting these, and I just wanted to go out into that wet paint, because again, we want the feeling of motion. And this guy is moving fast. I mean, he's jumping in into the fray. He says, "I'm the boss around this barnyard, and you better mind your business, or else." I can just hear the squabbling. Now let some of these feathers break over the wing. Bring some light here because I want it to pop on his head. This is a little bit of my mud with the liquid. I just want some darks here, so that helps give that dark. I'm going to switch brushes to my bigger bright brush. Again, that the bright brushes are the square brushes. And I just, over the years, I've worked with Filberts, I've worked with Rounds, and I just have come to really like the square bright brush. I can turn it and get a sharp edge, or using the flat, and I can cover a large area. Now I've saved my background color, so I can come in. I'm just going to add a little paint in here to drag those feathers. I'll probably cover up most of that, but I just want to get that all covered, so I don't end up with any white canvas showing through. But you can see how I'm using the brush sideways, and I can get a fine, get the feel of those fine feathers just. Going out into that background, just. Again, I don't know a whole lot about roosters, and I'm not sure if that's what they call pin. I don't think that's what they call pin feathers. I somehow think those are different, but somebody that knows more about roosters can write in and tell us. I guess I could also Google it, but since I'm painting right now, that won't work. Again, I want to soften that edge. And a little bit of the wing shows right in here where that wing comes over. And I know earlier I said something about that armpit right there, and I guess actually that would be a wing pit. Jack and I always kind of, it's like with the cats, we always call their paws hands and feet, so. I don't know, birds have arms. Their beaks are noses. Around the White House. The light's gonna be hitting in here, so. Give him a little more light. This is a mixture of my mud and a little cadmium orange and cadmium yellow medium. Just for my highlight. Mix I'm just using right now, I'm going to add a little more cadmium red light, a little white, and some cadmium orange just to make a little richer. Sienna. And I accentuate the colors a little bit more, but you can see how that's a little brighter, oranger. My reference material is over on the tabaret. I guess I can even show you. Let me just kind of move the camera here. I'll show you where I've got my reference for my roosters. This kind of, I'm moving the camera around and you can see how my setup is. And I've got my glass palette where I mix the paint. I've got my laptop with my reference material. And since I'm right-handed, I can look over to the right. And so that allows me to see what I'm working on and have my reference material right there. So, you see what I'm working from. We've collected pictures of roosters just all over the years. So I've got, oh my goodness, tons and tons. And I mix and match. And we'd be driving down the road, Jack and I would be, and there'd be a bunch of roosters, and I'd say, "Stop! Stop! I want to get pictures of those." And so he'd stop and back up, and we'd jump out and get pictures. It's wonderful when you've got a couple artists, because we both understood the value of reference material. We really had a great time. Lots of fun memories. These feathers on the neck are really fine. Just so I keep them pretty narrow. Now I'm getting even a smaller bright brush. So I'm going to come back and add a little highlights. Light pops off his head here. I also work with a mirror behind me, and that, Jack learned that from reading about Leonardo da Vinci. And da Vinci realized that when you look at your paintings in a mirror, that it switches it from the inventive side of your brain to the analytical side of your brain. And so you can judge your work a whole lot better. You can look at it almost like somebody else has painted it. So I have a mirror behind me, and I check my art in the mirror, and that way I can see if I need highlights somewhere, or if I'm working on a building or architecture, I can see if I don't, if my lines are straight up and down, or I need to do anything. So it's, a mirror is really essential for an artist to work with. If you don't have a mirror in your studio, you really need to set one up. It'll help you judge your painting, help you critique it. Because ultimately, we have to learn to critique our own work. Sometimes it's nice to have a second pair of eyes, but that's not always available. So you have to learn to look at your own work and judge it. Now this, on the other side of his neck, is darker. But these feathers come down his chest. The feathers, these neck feathers don't come all the way around his chest. They just kind of stop in the center. I'm going to let these flare out. I need a few more. Looking at my reference material, I need these to be a little bit longer. A few just ends showing here. Get the feeling that his, those feathers are really flared out. This guy's angry. Not a happy camper. I'm going to make them a little darker where they come up, rounded up around the comb. That's, and they come, his little ear thing around his eye. So that's the neck of this guy. Thank you for watching, and please feel free to make comments if you have any questions. I'm happy to answer. So you have a great day, and thank you for watching.